I would like to talk about the Voyager mission, United States missions, space missions to outside of the solar system, and the raging controversy, scientific controversy, about the heliosphere. And so the controversy is about where are the spacecraft. In fact, the spacecraft, we know very well where they are. They are one, Voyager 1 is at 126 astronomical units. That is the length between the Sun, the distance between the Sun and the Earth. And we are 126 times further out than that for Voyager 1. And today, which is August 2014. Voyager 2 is a smaller distance, 110 astronomical units. So I have to do a little bit of physics just to begin with. For a very long time, we know that the Sun is expelling some material, which is a plasma, a hot plasma composed mainly of protons and electrons, which is called the solar wind. Since already maybe 60 years, we know that this solar wind exists. But in fact, we could think that this solar wind is expanding in the vacuum, full vacuum, which is between the star. In principle, you have almost vacuum, so it could extend like this indefinitely. But in fact, we found out that, in particular, myself with my PhD advisor, Professor Blamont of the Academy of Science of France. In 1970, we discovered that the solar system with the Sun is moving across a cloud of interstellar hydrogen. We discovered that because we had one instrument on board, an American spacecraft, which could look at the light which is reflected by these hydrogen atoms which are flowing permanently within the solar system. And so we could find that this wind of hydrogen and helium was coming from a particular direction. And by chance, it is the approximate direction in which the Voyager 1 probes are going out of the solar system. But the fact that this flow is coming through the solar system has also an impact on the shape of the bubble of gas, which is spit by the Sun. This bubble of gas, we will call it the heliosphere. It is a region of space where you have solar wind. So, as I said, if the Sun were not moving, we would have a heliosphere which would be gigantic and spherical. But because there is this wind coming across the solar system, and because this wind is partially ionized, in fact, there is also an interstellar plasma, and everybody knows, everybody plasma physicists know that, in fact, these plasma cannot mix. So there is one plasma which is the plasma of the Sun, which is a heliosphere, and one interstellar plasma coming here, and they cannot mix. So in fact, it is as if there was a river on an obstacle, and then you have this border which separates the two plasma, and this border is called the heliopause. And it so happened that the heliopause was computed to be at about 150 astronomical units on the upstream front, but in the back, in the tail, it would be at 1,000 astronomical units or even more. Anyway, the two Voyagers are going upwind. One is going north, Voyager 1, and one is going south. And so we have the problem that for Voyager 2, we know we are still inside the heliopause. We are still inside the solar wind because there is one instrument which measures actually the solar wind. And we see very well that we have this plasma of protons and electrons. We measure the velocity, we measure the temperature. We know it is solar wind. So Voyager 2, there is no problem. We are inside the heliopause. But now for Voyager 1, there is a problem. It's because the solar wind instrument, which was also on Voyager 1, does not work anymore. So we have to use indirect measurement to understand if we are outside or inside the heliosphere. We are now at 126 astronomical units, so it is below the prediction of the Heliopause at 150 astronomical units, so we could be inside. But in fact, we know from some other measurements that we most likely are outside already. We use for this measurement of galactic cosmic rays. In the outer space, very far away from the Sun, there are plenty of galactic cosmic rays. These are very high energy particles, which when they penetrate in the solar system, they are more or less repelled a little bit or a lot by the magnetic field of the Sun. And this magnetic field, in fact, protects the whole inner solar system from these galactic cosmic rays. When you go outside of the solar system, further and further out from the Sun, you see that the galactic cosmic rays are increasing. And what happened in 2 years ago is that abruptly it was increasing very much and then it leveled. It's leveled as if we were already outside of the heliopause. So it leveled with very small fluctuation. At the same time, there was another type of cosmic rays, so-called anomalous cosmic rays, which we know are produced, which are relatively high energy particles, but much lower than the galactic cosmic rays. We know that they are produced within the solar system. We know that they are accelerated there, and we saw them increasing also. But all of a sudden, 2 years ago, they dropped almost to zero. And since we know that they are inside the heliopause, we could say we have two evidence to say, we have level off of galactic cosmic rays and a drop, complete drop of anomalous cosmic rays. So we must be outside of the heliosphere and we have crossed the so-called heliopause. But not all people were convinced, as a matter of fact. Because the reason is that the solar magnetic field, there is one instrument which measures the magnetic field, and we were all expecting that at the border of the heliopause, there should be a very much abrupt change of the magnetic field direction and perhaps magnitude. Because the two magnetic fields, the one from the solar magnetic field and the galactic magnetic field, they do not combine. They should be different, okay? At the interface, they should be different. One should flow like this and the other maybe like this, or okay. But the instrument measuring the magnetic field show practically no change when we cross this border where we see the two problems with the galactic cosmic rays and the anomalous cosmic rays. So for a certain time, though we had seen this phenomenon of the furious drop and leveling of the galactic, a number of people said, well, we have not crossed the heliopause yet. But then there was another measurement which measured electron density by some plasma wave interaction, and which find a very high local density, which meant that it was much higher than the predicted solar wind density. And this was an argument to say, well, we are now convinced that we have passed the heliopause 2 years ago. But this was rather strange because at the time we crossed, we did not say anything to the public, and then 1.5 years after that, we say, oh, we have crossed the heliopause, it was in 2012. So, anyway, almost all people are convinced that we are outside with Voyager 1, but not all of them. And some very good scientists, Mr. Len Fisk, the president of COSPAR now, and associate Glöckler, they claim that, in fact, it's not true. We are still inside the heliosphere, and they explain for a rather complicated matter. I will not go into it, but what is important is that, in fact, they made a prediction. Because, as you may know, the solar cycle of the 11-year solar cycle is, in fact, a 22-year solar cycle, because the magnetic field is changing from one polarity to the other. And so this flip of magnetic field, not only it is near the sun, but also propagates very fast to the border of the heliosphere. So they predict, Dr. Fisk and Dr. Glockler, they predict that because we are still in the heliosphere, the magnetic field, which is sensed by Voyager 1, will flip 180 degrees sometime in the year 2015. So it is not far from now. But if they are not right, there will be no flip of the magnetic field. So it is a kind of very good example where there is a controversy, very serious controversy, but there is a clear diagnostic, a prediction. And so we will know in 2 years we will know who was right. And so I think it is a very interesting example in science that you make a prediction and you will see who was right. And so this Voyager spacecraft, after that, I am personally convinced that we are already at the, we have crossed the heliopause, we are outside of the heliosphere, and will continue its travel through the interstellar space.